Representative Lundberg.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. The sponsor yield.
I yield.
Sponsor, you've said this is, you don't feel this is a mandate, but candidly, it still is.
That's your opinion. I don't feel like it is.
Are we mandating that this be covered?
The insurance companies are going to put it on their policies.
And I appreciate this bill. As you know, I've had trouble with it. In my district, I had a letter from a family who talked about their six-year-old. And what they said was this six-year-old, all they wanted for Christmas was a new pair of hearing aids. And that's tough for me because I empathize and what you're doing and why I agree with. On the other side, Representative Weaver, just a few weeks ago, eloquently stood up and talked about the Health Care Freedom Act and talked about how it is not our place to create mandates. You talked about choice. You talked about freedom individually. And now we do it on a business community. But right now, we don't mandate dental care. We don't mandate eye care. We have specifically in this legislation, as it's before us, exempted 10 care from it. So we as state government don't have to take part.
They're already doing it.
But and most private insurance companies are already doing that.
Yeah.
And I know it's not a lot of cost. It's $48,000. But what I'd ask the sponsor, because I need to know and for myself, is where is the line that we draw? Where is the line that we draw on what's a good mandate and what's not?
You know, as you know, and you've been here a number of years now, and it's very hard to get a mandate passed down here because we don't support mandates. And it's going to cause a real burden on a business or on a family. We don't support that. This is what we're talking about with this one. We were able to know what the cap was. We were able to know what the cost was going to be and how it was going to calculate into the policy. I mean, all this was calculated out before we ever did this. It's not like we went in blind and said, we're going to pass a mandate, and I don't know what it's going to cost, the people. So we tried to be very, very careful that we were hitting the target that we were after.
And I understand that, and I respect the representative from Carter County who talked before about NFIB, and I have not had vast discussions there. I do have this feeling, though, as a small business person. I currently own three companies, and we did provide 100% of health insurance for our employees. A couple of years ago, we went to 80%, and one of our companies has been in existence 18 years. I consider it personally one of the saddest things I had to do when I dropped that down to 80%, because I think that's important. I think this becomes a slow erosion of what we do and what we pass on to businesses, because it's inevitable. This didn't cost a lot. It won't. Sometime in the future, I'm going to have to cut that back. And somebody's going to go at some point, one of my employees is going to go, you know, I can't afford the 40% for my health care, and we're going to pull that out. And we've exempted 10 care because they do it, but we also exempted 10 care because if this becomes so expensive in the future, they can pull themselves out. What we're doing is not going to let anyone else come out. We're going to mandate that. And again, Representative Chairman, I have the utmost respect for you, and I understand, and it's difficult for me because, as I told you, that letter that I came from my district came not long ago. And as all of us know up here, it's very difficult when you get those stories from someone in your district to look them in the eye and say, I can't support you because of this. But I also think that we were sent up here and we talk about all the other mandates that are coming out. And then we go, but this one's okay. I don't know where to draw the line. And when I come up here, and I think the folks have sent all of us up here to set policy, I've got to say, I can't do this. And to the sponsor, thank you. Representative, Madam Speaker, thank you.
Representative Lundberg, let me say I appreciate your comments. I truly do, because you've got a perspective there that we needed to hear, and I appreciate that. Let me just mention one other situation that really hadn't been spoke of today. Can you imagine if a child does not have a hearing aid, they cannot hear, where are they going to end up? They're going to end up in special education. Now, how much is that going to cost our education system? You know, this is absolutely preventive. Preventive medicine is what this is, and to really help children. So I just wanted to bring that point to you.